powerful effects, new moves and good standards. The flyout is one of the most powerful moves. But how to control all these attributes perfect? I show you how easy it could be to control these famous effects with all the different attributes. Let's create a flyout. The flyout is maybe one of the most powerful effects on light shows. First, I select my spots. The flyout consists just on two steps: a roof position with full intensity and a default or straight position with 0% intensity. Okay, let's clear the programmer. And the first step consists on a down position. And the next parameter, I have to integrate the blackout. I select my second step and I integrate the intensity full. So dimmer starts directly with running. And also I integrate for the second step the roof position. I like to slow down it a little bit. I choose both of my steps and set the speed to 20. Now I have the basic move. Next step is bring down the transition for the intensity. The movement should be smooth, but the intensity has to have a hard cut. For that, I go inside of my add filter, deselect all attributes and select only the dimmer. Now I give the transition for the dimmer to 0. And what I now see, the attributes dimmer and movement are not synchronized. For that, I have this sync button. And when I tap on it, the both attributes get the same face. Now the face is a little bit nicer. We have this typical move up with the light and move down in the dark. Next is, I like that the move back is faster. We don't have to see that we don't see that, so it could be faster. For that, I activate all my checkboxes again. And just for the step one, I set the width to 30. Now I have the effect that the movement up is slow and backwards it's much faster. There is something more that I don't like. In that moment, when the fixtures come to intensity full, it crashes inside. I like to have just this upcoming of the lights a little bit smoother. I deactivate the checkboxes for the position that I only control the intensity, and I need the step 2 because the full intensity is step 2, and I set the transition to 10. So that is much nicer. I select again all checkboxes that I can control all the attributes, select both steps and give a face of 360. And my flyout is ready. If I like to randomize the lights a little bit, it's able to use matrix, set something and give a face again. And so I have more random style. And when I now like to give a gobo, it doesn't work because of I have to check my add filter. Here I have to select all the attributes again. And now I can select my gobo and have this nice flyout. So, if you like to know more about the Grandma 3, then visit my homepage. There you will find a lot of videos that are not on YouTube. And for beginners of the Grandma 3, you will find a complete Grandma 3 basic training with more than 50 lessons. My name is Fietz, and if you like this video, please leave a comment below.